When I heard about going to Taizé, I think what attracted me was just being away from like everything, being away from the norm basically, because we're so used to being around friends and family and people that we know. So we have these programmed responses to things, and it would be nice to sort of get a new experience.
We are quite distracted by school and home life, and I think it's nice to get away and to go somewhere else.
Being in a city environment, it's you're not used to going to somewhere where it's more remote in a rural area, and you don't know that it's less busy. Like it's here, it's bam, 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 bam.
I think because you get a wider range of experience being away from home, away from your local area, because there's so much out there in the world to experience.
Things just happen so quickly in like your late teens, 20s, I think. I think they probably find it quite overwhelming. There's so much that happens, and there's not really integration into it. You just get dropped straight into like the adult world, and it's just kind of overwhelming, really. It's terrifying.
The only thing that's constant in life is change. You need to be able to adapt to new people and build new relationships. You're not going to live in your natural habitat, if I may say, forever. You're going to move to, you know, different schools, different jobs. So having, you know, this opportunity to meet new people is kind of like the basis to getting used to that fact.
I suppose Taizé could help with this whole kind of this fear of life. I'm doing things I've never done before, and a lot of it I probably will find quite daunting.
I hope I come home with a sense of that it was a good thing to do. I don't want to have any regret that I went and it hasn't, you know, affected me or influenced me. And I want to enjoy it, you know, because I've made that choice to go. I think it will benefit me.
Every year, lots of young people around the world spend time at Taizé,
an ecumenical monastery in eastern France,
taking part in the life of the brothers.
It can be a good time to reflect on your life,
meet people from different cultures,
and enjoy yourself.
In the summer, groups of young people from UK schools visit,
and some of us carried around a camera and recorded our experience.
Okay, so this is our camp. It's pretty good, all set up, all tents and everything.
So at 10:15 we have like a Bible introduction, and Brother Timothy talks us through like some themed Bible studies, and then we just afterwards we get into our small groups, and as you can see behind me, that's where we go into that tent, and there's about 200 or so of us. I'll take you in there to show you, look, see?
So the Bible introduction thingy started.
She always said, the brothers also, we don't know better than somebody else how to pray. Everybody knows how to pray.
It's been quite good. As you can see, we have 10 cameras. Everyone's here together, just French speakers, English speaking, German speaking.
Okay, so just finished Bible study. It was really enjoyable, actually. I learned so much about my group members and their feelings and attitudes towards faith. It was a really eye-opening session.
At 10:45, we normally go into our small groups. So we're in groups of 10, where basically we meet with people with different languages.
This is our group, well, about half of it. So we have English, German, Swiss, Austrian.
Today, I spent a lot of time with the small groups. We would spend maybe half an hour to an hour discussing questions that they'd given us on a Bible text. One question was, how does your faith affect your life? And I don't really have any faith in anything at all. Not really. And so, obviously, that's nearly impossible for me to answer. But I guess one of the joys of Taizé is the fact that that didn't bother anyone. We could work around that. Everyone was very respectful about what we all had to say to each other. And I thought that was really good. When we'd finished that, we just hung around for maybe the next 2 hours. It's really giving us a chance to get to know these people. And experience this whole community feeling, I guess.
So these people standing around here, these are groups made up of people from all over the world. And most of these people hadn't met each other till yesterday. But still they're hanging around and getting to know each other and playing games. I mean, that's crazy.
It was just kind of really nice to see that even though there was like a culture barrier, a language barrier, we all have kind of like very similar lives. We all have the same kind of problems.
So at 1 o'clock we normally have lunch.
Basically what happens is we queue and we have a lunch ticket.
You got your lunch ticket on you?
Yeah. Take off. So we've got, and it's blue, and then they just rip it, and we're going to go and see if we can volunteer
right.
to give out lunch. And look, if you look,
really
if you look over there, that's where we all queue.
You can tell we're not in England because we're clearly not queuing. It's more of a scrum.
Everyone like bunches forward, and it's like a massive wave of hungry people pressing forward into the food line. And I love that because it's such a feeling of unity that everyone's hungry and everyone wants to get this food. And I love that. I love the community feel that's here.
I was just on my way to meet some friends, and then all of a sudden, one of the helpers in the kitchen was like, oh, can you help us do the dishes? I'm like, yeah, no problem.
And this right here is the kitchen of Taizé. How are you doing? This is the greatest place in the world. Yes, we have the kitchen staff here ready to wash every dish at the push of a button.
Washing up the dishes turned out to be the funnest thing I did today, you know? You know, we made friends like that. It was crazy. I didn't see it coming.
I am on my way to my first job of the day.
So, just got here to my job site. Just found out that I'm going to build a tent with some people. But not just any tent. It's a tent that's about... yeah, it's quite huge. And as you can tell by both the sound of my voice and the look of myself, I am not one for manual labor. But I hope that the group will... Yep, I'm being called. We are currently in the process of making this omega-sized tent. I am not cut out for heavy labor, but you know what? It's been a great experience. One of the things that made me think so much was we started off fixing a tent. It was a shock because it made me think about how much I can accomplish when I'm put to the test. Because usually when you're back home and you know, wherever you are, and you're living in the hustle and bustle, like because I live near the city, I'm used to things moving so fast-paced that you don't have the time to step back and think. And here I was given the chance to do something that really, I guess it opened my eyes to what I can actually do with myself. All right, so we're about to go and interview, Brother Stephen. We've got some questions that we pre-prepared, so in the room, and here we go.
Why do you think so many young people come here to Taizé?
Community is one of the biggest reasons. I hope in Taizé everybody feels respected for who they are. And in the meetings, I feel that people do treat each other very well. You feel part of something. I don't know. I think the saddest thing in the world today is for many people, they don't feel as if they belong. They don't feel as though they belong to a community or to a group or something.
Yeah.
And in Taizé, for many people, there is this immediate feeling that I belong. This is my place, and I am responsible for giving out the evening meal, or I am responsible for cleaning the showers. Or and since I have this job, then I am part of the place somehow.
How do you deal with the facts that people don't exactly believe in a god?
In Taizé, everybody is welcome to come here, and you don't have to sign a paper before you come. I mean, we are all searchers. We are all on the same level of searching for truth in our lives, searching for meaning in our lives.
What kind of advice would you give a young person who's trying to discover their faith?
I mean, the advice I would give is to listen to yourself, you know. And I hope that's one of the things that happens here. An old man, he wrote us a beautiful letter a couple of years ago. He was dying of cancer. And he wrote to the brothers and he said, please continue to listen to the young people and to listen to them and to listen to them until they hear their own voices. And for me, that would be the advice, is to hear your own voice.
Okay, so this is actually where the church is. This is where they have morning, afternoon, and evening prayers. And funny enough, I've prayed here more times than I have in my entire life. I'm in the church now, so I'd randomly, you know, show you guys around a little bit. So everyone literally sits around here, either on benches or on the floor.
Okay, so at 12:30, we normally have our midday prayer. This is where we are now.
We are about to start our church service.
So this is the hymn book that we use. And it has all the songs in there that we sing, and it comes up on a board, on a monitor, up there. Our favourite song. Where is it? Number 70. Hallelujah. This is me and the lad's favourite song. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The worship is amazing. Literally. It's so peaceful. It's so nice. It's so silent. There's some chanting, there's some singing.
The singing, it did something to me. There was something about that presence. There was such a communal effort. Everyone was, you know, putting in their all to praise God, and it was different because I'm used to the more gospel, you know, praise break, dancing up and down kind of thing. That is my thing. But here in Taizé, it's so stripped down that you're able to reflect whilst you're hearing all these amazing sounds.
Church, we have this silence where everyone just remains silent for a while, and to be honest, like the silent prayer, I find it quite relaxing in a way. It gives me a chance to reflect on myself and also to see that the whole community is like equal. We just like remain together as one.
I learned that I can actually stay still in church. That silence is kind of healing. That when I'm in church and it's silent, it just gives me time to recollect everything and just sort it out in my head.
In my life, there really isn't much space for silence. I can't really think of anywhere where I get any silence, but here in Taizé, there's plenty of it, and there are plenty of places you can go to experience just no noise and no interruption, nothing but you.
Even if you're not thinking about anything, you can just think. And I think that's quite effective.
The songs were really powerful today, actually. I mean, I just thought about all my short time at Taizé, and how it's affected me as a person. And, you know, I never really imagined myself praying 3 times a day, every day of the week, you know. So, yeah, I'll keep you posted.
Right, so we're off to Oyak now for the evening, and play some guitars, have some fun. Yeah!
At the Oyak. And the Oyak is where everyone gets to come to chill, to have fun, to play music.
And this is Oyak.
Last night in the Oyak, we had a random jamming session where a guy was playing guitar and some other guy was playing saxophone. And I was like, you know what? Usually back home in London, I wouldn't have even tried. But I said, you know what? Can I join? And they were like, fine.
Oh, yeah.
I've never experienced people just so open. You can just go up to anyone, ask them, like, what's your name? Where are you from? How are you doing? How long have you been here? Kind of thing, first time. And I think that's just fantastic, really.
It's kind of hard to express it because I've never really seen that side of me before where I just go up and randomly talk to people. I guess I feel it's because like, people aren't really as judgmental about you. They don't care where you're from or anything, or religion or skin colour or anything like that. Like, they just accept you for who you are. And so I think that's what makes the Taizé community what it is, really.
Back at home, you know, Bromley, you know, if you were to just walk over to someone and go, hi, I'm Georgie, where are you from? What's your name? People look at you like, what are you doing? And here, go to someone, you know, you introduce yourself and they're fine, you know, you're like best friends in 5 minutes. And that's really nice. That makes you think, wow, Taizé is for everyone. Nobody minds, nobody cares if you go over and, you know, you're a bit weird or a bit unknown, you know.
You know, back at home, I'd always be like, oh no, I can't talk to people, I have problems because I didn't really have a good childhood back then. I think Taizé just taken stress all away. I feel grateful for it, really. I mean, I've never really felt like this before. I've never been so relaxed in my whole life. I think that's quite nice.
I kind of discovered that I'm not as kind of socially inept as I thought, because I've managed to make so many friends and it's just fantastic.
This is the only place I've been able to be confident, not shy, not worried, not afraid, just been able to talk to people.
Alright, so it's the final day today, and basically we've just gotten up and it's about quarter to eight now. So yeah, we're gonna go to church in a bit, and today we're gonna get our stuff packed up and ready to go.
The things that I think are necessities are not really necessities, like my phone or my favourite chocolate or my favourite drink. Because even though when I'm at home, every morning I'll buy the same thing, and I think that I can't function without it. I've been here for a week and I've been functioning quite well. And like my phone, I think that when I'm at home and I don't have my phone, I panic because I don't really know what's going on. But here, I don't. There's no connection, so I can't use it, and then it's just made me realise that I don't really need it as much as I think I do.
I do want to come back. I love it here, even though there's no TV, there's no McDonald's, there's, you know, but there's people, there's real people. That's the difference. There's real people that you know that you can be friends with, that you know you can talk to. It's easy to approach people, it's easy to do stuff with people, it's easy to ask people to do stuff for you, it's easy to help people.
You find yourself as well. That's why it's called pilgrimage and worst stuff. Hardly skills. Yeah, it's been nice talking to you. Thank you very much.
Right, so we're leaving, and it's been a good experience. Just made a lot of new friends, and I hope to come back next year, definitely.
See you later.
Bye. Oh, don't cry.
It's had like a positive impact. It opened my eyes to a lot of things. I'm more quieter. Like, I used to be like quite loud in class and stuff, and like when I'm at home, much more calmer and mellow.
I think what stayed with me the most is the group work. What other people have to say that you might have never thought about before, and yeah, that's the first thing that comes to them.
I got the impression that there were lots of faiths there and lots of different religious backgrounds, and there isn't any pressure at all to feel or think anything that they want you to. And even though it's Christian based, it's very much up to you on your opinion of that.
This was a place where everyone was equal. Everyone ate the same food, everyone experienced the same weather, everyone slept in the same tents.
I was able to just, I guess, reflect on my life and how it's been, and obviously think of the future as well. And from that point on, I was able to go, okay, this is me. I could see myself in full scope, in full view, and understand that I have good points and bad points. And I was able to work on that in Taizé just because of that atmosphere, being able to be free with myself.
I felt that I'm a lot more confident in myself, in the way I talk to people. I sort of learnt that it doesn't matter what, you know, people think of you as much.
I really think it really has helped, actually, because I feel a lot more confident in myself, and I feel a lot happier being who I am, because it kind of taught me that it doesn't really matter, because people there didn't judge you at all. And I think it kind of just showed me that I'm just fine the way I am.
The main thing I got from Taizé was just the whole community-based society, being together, living together, you know, and giving, you know, to each other. And that's one thing that's actually helped me, because I've moved out of the house, I'm now in university, and living with new people has not been easy. But the patience and the skills that I've gathered from being at Taizé really helps me to build up a really good relationship and, you know, community-based one with my housemates and, you know, my teammates and my group work at school. And yeah, that's one thing that will stay with me.
You just begin to take comfort knowing that there is a place like Taizé. And so that kind of, how comfortable you are there, you know that that is possible. And I guess that in itself is a comfort when you're struggling in the normal world.
If I were to sum up the experience in one word, it would be magical.
Enchanting. Friendship.
Peaceful.
Extraordinary.
Family.
Special.